So students, we will continue with the previous chapter, that is how do organisms reproduce. Okay, so in the last class we were discussing about the asexual method of reproduction in unicellular organisms or in simple multicellular organisms. So we discussed binary fission and the multiple fission in unicellular organisms. Okay, so today we will discuss other methods of reproduction in or other methods of asexual reproduction in simple multicellular organisms or unicellular organism. Now is the fragmentation. What is fragmentation? What do you mean by fragments? Means small pieces. So fragmentation, in fragmentation, parent body, it breaks into two or more fragments, either by mechanical injury or maybe the fragments or the organism on maturation divides or breaks into fragments, and each fragment then grows up into a new organism. I hope it is clear to everyone. Okay, what is fragmentation? Okay, now children, fragmentation generally takes place in the multicellular organisms. But which multicellular organisms? Simple multicellular organisms, because they have same type of cells. Okay, so it takes place in the simple multicellular organisms. There are two types of organisms. One is simple multicellular organism, another one is complex multicellular organisms. In complex multicellular organisms, there are different types of cells, and then these different types of cells form tissues which forms organs and which are placed in the human body in a very organized pattern. I hope it is clear. Simple multicellular and complex multicellular. In simple multicellular organisms, what is there? All the same cells are similar to each other. But this is not true for all multicellular organisms, because they cannot simply divide cell by cell. The reason is that many multicellular organisms, as we have seen, are not simply a random collection of cells. Okay, so in human beings, what happens? The specialized cells, they form tissues, they form organs, and then they are organized into a organ system. Understood or no? So here, cell to cell division is impractical, that is not possible. Okay, so fragmentation, the example of fragmentation is Spirogyra. You can see in the picture also. What is Spirogyra? Spirogyra is the algae. You can see here, there are cells, you can see cells, rectangular cells, and each cell, and in each cell there is a, you can see this green spiral arranged thing, this is the spiral chloroplast. And here you can see the nucleus is also present, and this spiral chloroplast contains chlorophyll which performs photosynthesis. Here you can also see that the Spirogyra is broken into fragments, and then these fragments, they grow up into a individual, complete individual. I hope it is clear to everyone. Just see in the picture. Okay, now children, what is regeneration? What do you understand by regeneration? Anyone can answer? Regeneration. Children, regeneration, it is a natural process. Okay, of replacing and restoring damaged or missing cells, tissues, organs, and even entire body parts to full function in plants and animals. I hope everyone have understood what is regeneration. Regeneration is that when the damaged body parts are replaced, or the body parts or the cells or the tissues or the organs, they are replaced. Okay, understood or no? And this power of regeneration, that is utilized by some organisms for asexual reproduction and multiplication. So this method of regeneration can also be used for reproduction. Example are simple organisms like Hydra and Planaria. They show reproduction. If they are cut into several parts, then each part grows into a new complete organism. आई होप एवरी वन हैज अंडरस्टूड दिस थिंग. वॉट इज रीजेनरेशन? ओके, यू कैन सी इन द स्लाइड ऑल्सो वॉट इज रीजेनरेशन. नाउ हेयर यू कैन सी हेयर ऑल ऑफ यू. सो द एग्जाम्पल ऑफ रीजेनरेशन इज प्लानेरिया एंड इट टेक्स प्लेस इन हाइड्रा ऑल्सो. Understood? So here the body parts are cut and each body part again grows into a full individual. Now regeneration in organism is why? Because here what is happened? The lost body parts can be regenerated. So regeneration in organism, how it happens? How it takes place? How regeneration takes place? What is regeneration? That is to replace the, to restore the lost body part. Now here what happens? There are certain specialized cells. Okay, regeneration in an organism is due to the presence of some specialized cells which proliferate, okay, and they increase large number of cells. Understood? So here there are certain cells. What these cells do? They divide, okay, and then they differentiate, okay, and they form various tissues and organ. So in the planaria, see, you can see it is cut and this planaria grows into a new individual. So how it happens? Because there are certain specialized cells, there is a cluster of cells and these cells, they differentiate into different body organs. Understood or no? They differentiate into various tissues and organs. Is it clear? So you can see here the diagram of planaria. I hope it is clear to everyone. Now we come to another method of sexual reproduction, that is budding. What is the name given? Budding. So it is also a asexual method of regeneration. You can even see the regeneration in Hydra also. You can see here it's got amputation and each part will grow. Now we come to budding. Budding is what? It is also a type of reproduction also. It is only a, it is a type of reproduction. And what happens here? Here, a small bud is formed. Okay? And this bud, it grows, it matures, and then it is detached from the parent individual. It is detached from the parent. Understood? So, examples are yeast and hydra. In both yeast and hydra, what happens? A small bud is developed and that bud grows, it matures and finally it detaches from the parent and grows as an individual. So that is bud. So it in hydra also a small bud is formed and even in yeast also a small bud is formed as you can see here. You can see in budding in hydra, can you see a small bud is growing? Okay, growth of a bud. A small bud is growing, then you can see here it has just started and it has started the grow. You can see it, it is growing and then what will happen? This bud will grow more. Okay, first you can see in budding in Hydra, so formation of bud has started, then the bud grows and then the mouth and the tentacles also appears and finally it gets separated from the parent. So that is budding in Hydra. And what happens in the yeast? In yeast also, yeast is a unicellular organism. Here also the reproduction takes place by budding. Hydra is a simple multicellular organism. Here the reproduction takes place by budding. And even in Hydra, the regeneration also takes place. Now you can see reproduction in yeast by budding. Can you see? This is the yeast cell where one is written. From here the bud will grow. Bud will initiate. Okay. So here the bud will be formed. Okay, you can see it is subswollen thing. So here the bud is formed. So number two, you can see the bud is formed. And after that, what will happen? The nucleus in the parent bud, the nucleus is also there. So this nucleus will divide and it will go to the bud which is formed. In three, you see this bud has pinched. The cell membrane, it is pinched off and this bud nucleus will go into the bud and finally the bud will fall down. But sometimes what happens, the reproduction, the formation of bud is so fast that before it falls down, the another bud appears and it gives the appearance as a chain of buds. I hope it is clear to everyone, budding. Now we come to vegetative propagation. Students, first thing I would like to ask is, what do you mean by vegetative parts? Vegetative parts of a plant. Children, vegetative parts of the plants are leaves, roots, stems, buds. They all are the vegetative parts of the plants. Now, what do you mean by vegetative reproduction? Vegetative reproduction means that these vegetative parts are able to give rise to a new individuals, and it takes place only in plants. So vegetative reproduction is also called as vegetative propagation. It means that here the vegetative parts of the plants, that is roots, stems, leaves, buds, are able to form a new individual, and this is an asexual mode of reproduction, because here the male and the female parents are not involved. Here the male and female gametes are not formed. Fusion of male and female gametes does not take place. So that is why it is an asexual reproduction. Only one parent is involved here. Okay, so the opposite gametes are, male and female gametes are not formed. I hope it is clear to everyone. Vegetative reproduction, okay, it takes place only in plants. Okay, children, now in detail we will discuss in next class, that the how the stem is used to give a full plant, or how the leaves are used. Okay, now, but one thing I would like to say, in this picture you can see in the leaf, can you see here in the leaf, can you see small leaflets? These are the small leaves which are formed. So after some time, these leaves will grow, they will fall down, and so many new plants will be formed. Okay. Now, children, vegetative propagation or vegetative reproduction, in this only one parent is involved. Okay. So, what are the advantages? Here, exact copies of parent plants can be produced in most cases. Exact copies are produced, because only one parent is involved, so the character of that parent will only come. It is simple and it is very quick. It takes place in short time. Large number of plants can sometimes be produced in short period of time. Good quality and uniformity among plants are produced, and it is economical also. It doesn't need much care. It is cheap also. And it takes place in those plants which cannot be propagated by sexual methods. It takes place in those plants where the seed produced is sterile. So sterile seed will not give rise to a new plant. So the asexual method is used there. Okay. Now, these are some of the advantages of vegetative reproduction. Here the new plants produced are genetically similar to each other. Okay, now in detail we will discuss in next class. Okay, so after you the class you after you watch the video, just go through, just revise it, and if you have any doubt, please clarify your doubts from me. Okay, students, thank you, students.